Good morning, children. Hope you all are safe. Have you had your breakfast? Oh yes. So you have a lot of energy to study a new topic, isn't it? Okay. Before that, I have a question for you. Have you heard about yogasanas? Yes. So before we are going to our topic, I will demonstrate some simple yogasanas, some simple breathing exercises. You should watch it carefully and then try to do this. Okay? Okay, let us start. Are you ready to do the breathing exercise? Okay, for this breathing exercise, you should first close your right nostril with your thumb and then take a deep breath through your left nostrils. And with your third finger, close the nostrils and hold the breath for some time. Then release the breath through right nostrils. This is the simple breathing exercise. And it should be done 2 to 3 times alternatively through left nostril and also right nostrils. Let us start. Okay, I will demonstrate it first. Then you try to do this. Are you watching carefully? Okay, then keep doing with me. Okay, after doing this breathing exercise, what will you feel now? Yes, feeling energetic, feeling active, then feel fresh. Yes, what will happen? Our energy level increases. Then can you know how does this energy level increases when we breathe deeply? Yes, it is released in the cells. The energy is released in the cells when we breathe deeply. Can you name the system that helps in this intake of oxygen from the atmosphere? Yes, respiratory system. And in this class, we are going to study about respiratory system. After this class, you will be able to identify the parts of respiratory system. And also, the deep breathing has many benefits. It helps in increasing the blood circulation, increases the lung capacity or the volume of lungs, and also it helps to release our stress. So students, all of you try to do breathing exercise daily for your better health. Now we are going to discuss our topic, respiratory system.
Let's start our topic, respiratory system. Going to our objectives of the lesson. First one, to identify the parts of respiratory system. Second one, to list out the functions of parts of respiratory system. Third one, to accept the benefits of deep breathing exercise in life.
First of all, we are going to do an activity, and the activity is model analysis. For this, I will show you a model of respiratory system. And this is the model of our respiratory system. And in this activity, you should identify the parts labeled as 1, 2, 3 and 4. I will be also giving some hints. Based on that hints, you will identify the parts of this improvised model of respiratory system. And the time allotted for this activity is only 6 minutes. And write down the parts labeled as 1, 2, 3 and 4 in your notebook. Start now.
This is the improvised model of the lungs. You should analyze the given improvised model of lungs. Then identify the parts labeled as 1, 2, 3 and 4. Identify and write in your notebook without any spelling errors. And the time allotted for this activity is 6 minutes. Start doing it.
Hope you all complete the activity. Then look at this model. What is this part? Yes, it is trachea. And the second part is bronchus. And third one is the bronchiole. This is the bronchiole. And this last part is the alveoli.
Now, let us understand what is a respiratory system. A respiratory system consists of the set of organs and tissues involved in the uptake of oxygen from the atmosphere and release of carbon dioxide. This is a simple definition for respiratory system. Then moving to the parts of respiratory system. Respiratory system helps to take oxygen from the atmospheric air into the body. The parts of respiratory system are: first one, nostrils; second one, nasal cavity; third one, trachea; fourth one, bronchus; fifth one, bronchiole; and the last one is alveoli. Pleura. It is the double-layered protective membrane of the lungs. Diaphragm. It is the muscular wall that separates the thoracic cavity and also the abdominal cavities.
So, we are moving to our second activity, and the second activity is a flowchart preparation. In this activity, you should prepare a flowchart on the pathway of air from the nostrils to the alveoli. And the instructions will be given.
Instructions for flowchart preparation. You should prepare a flowchart on the pathway of air from nostrils to the alveoli. Then write it in your science diary. Time allotted for this activity is only 6 minutes. Your time starts now.
Hope you all prepare the flowchart. Okay, then I will show you an animation video on the respiratory system. Please do watch it carefully.
We take in air or inhale through nose or mouth. Breathing through nose is better as mucus and hairs in the nasal cavity can filter out lots of dirt from the air. Then the air enters trachea or windpipe through pharynx or throat. This pharynx has one more opening which leads to food pipe. Now, air passes through the windpipe, then the two bronchi, which forms many narrower branches called bronchioles. Small air sacs or alveoli receive the air, and oxygen from air diffuses into blood through thin wall of blood capillaries during the diffusion process. Blood cannot exchange gases absorbed in water in this arrangement. Hence, we can't breathe in water. How do we breathe the air out? The diaphragm moves downward, creating space for the lungs to expand, decreasing the air pressure in lungs. When diaphragm moves up, putting pressure on the lungs, then the air from the lungs moves out of the body or gets exhaled. Taking the reversed path, that is bronchiole, bronchi, windpipe, pharynx, then nose or mouth.
We do this process, that is, inhaling and exhaling 12 to 20 times per minute.
Now, let us check your flowchart. Do you get the same answer like this flowchart? Okay, let us check. The oxygen-rich air from the environment first enters into the nasal cavity, and from the nasal cavity, the oxygen-rich air enters into the pharynx. From pharynx, it enters into the trachea, and from the trachea, it enters into the bronchioles through bronchi, and at last, the oxygen-rich air enters into the alveoli, and the oxygen and carbon dioxide exchange takes place at alveoli. From alveoli, the carbon dioxide goes back into the bronchioles and then into bronchi, then into the trachea. From the trachea, it enters into the pharynx. From pharynx, the carbon dioxide enters into the nasal cavity. Like this, the carbon dioxide rich air back into the environment.
Now, we are familiar with the pathway of air from nostrils to the alveoli. Then let us look at the functions or the peculiarities of the parts of respiratory system.
Now, we are going to look at the peculiarities of the parts of respiratory system. The first part is the nostril. Nostril is an opening through which air passes in and out of body. Second one, nasal cavity. Nasal cavity is the cavity which connects nostrils with the pharynx. Next one is the trachea. Trachea is a long tube strengthened by C-shaped cartilaginous rings. Next part is the bronchus. Bronchus is the branches of trachea which enter the lungs. The bronchus is supported by cartilaginous bronchial rings. Next part is the bronchiole. Bronchiole is the terminal branches of bronchi that open to the alveoli. Alveoli are the delicate air sacs. They are elastic in nature, helps in the exchange of gases.
We know that the respiratory system helps to take in oxygen and also get rid of carbon dioxide. Likewise, in life, we should only take in the positive things and get rid of the negative things. Now, let us recapitulate our topic. For this, I will be giving a small activity. And the activity is that I will be giving some jumbled words related to our topic, respiratory system. You should identify that words. And the time allotted for this activity is only 3 minutes. Try to do.
This is the activity for recapitulation. In this activity, you should identify the given jumbled words. And the time allotted for this activity is only 3 minutes. Try to do it. Hope you all get the correct answers. The first one is trachea, second is alveoli, third is bronchus, fourth one is nostril, and the fifth one is bronchiole.
So, in this class, we discussed about respiratory system and its parts. Hope you all understand the topic. Do you have any doubts? Okay. So, I will be giving some questions for your follow-up activity. Try to do that questions.
These are the questions for follow-up activity. Write down these questions in your science diary. First question, prepare an improvised model of respiratory system. Second one, write 4 benefits of deep breathing. Third one, prepare a poster to make people aware about benefits of deep breathing. Please note down these questions in your science diary. Thank you.